In the past 48 hours, two suspicious earthquake swarms began at distant volcanoes in Iceland. One occurred at the towering Katla volcano, while the other occurred at the submarine Eldey volcano. On October 16th at 8:15 a.m. local time, a series of three earthquakes struck a shallow submarine ridge 50 kilometers west-southwest of the edge of the Reykjanes Peninsula. Since this area is an active divergent plate boundary, not much thought was immediately put into these earthquakes. Then, 12 hours later, another small group of earthquakes occurred in the same location. And, beginning at 10:04 p.m. local time, a series of 40 earthquakes occurred in essentially the same spot, the largest of which was a magnitude 4.4. Although not a certainty, what had just occurred had a decent possibility of being linked to volcanic activity. You see, a 60-kilometer stretch of the mid-ocean ridge contains a cluster of submarine vents and above-sea-level volcanic edifices known as the Eldey Volcanic Complex. There, the Eurasian plate is spreading apart from the North American plate. Material from the mantle then is forced upwards to fill the gap in between the two plates, forming new oceanic crust and on occasion triggering volcanic eruptions at nearby vents. This complex has erupted 6 times since Iceland was settled, the last of which occurred in 1926. These 6 eruptions were for the most part quite explosive due to a simple factor. When lava interacts with seawater at shallow depths, it creates a series of powerful explosions with a white and black eruption plume in what is known as a Sertsayan eruption. The depth of the water ranges from 250 meters to less than 15 meters, meaning a deeper eruption will be less explosive. The earthquakes which occurred on October 16th took place at a depth between 7 and 15 kilometers, which places them in the upper mantle and lower crust. Although the cause of this swarm is unclear, the quakes which occurred seem to fit well with a small magmatic intrusion. If these quakes were instead related to the spreading of the mid-ocean ridge, they would most likely have occurred over a wider area. As it stands right now, the quakes have occurred over a 70 square kilometer region. However, earthquake swarms of a similar intensity have occurred about a half dozen times since 1990, and none of those resulted in a new volcanic eruption. With this being said, if the earthquake swarm was magmatic and did somehow lead to a volcanic eruption, it would result in one of two eruption types. The first type would be a completely effusive submarine eruption, probably at a depth of greater than 200 meters. The only notable evidence that such an eruption was occurring would be large patches of discolored water. However, if an eruption occurred at shallow depths, it would have a decent chance of forming a new volcanic island, much like the recent eruption of Home Reef in Tonga. Such an island might wash away quite quickly, being built out of a combination of basaltic ash and lava, but could also remain for some time. While this seismic unrest was ongoing, another earthquake swarm occurred on the same day at the Katla volcano, beginning at 1:39 a.m. local time. Over the next several hours, 20 likely volcano tectonic quakes occurred at shallow depths beneath the eastern section of the subglacial stratovolcano. These suspiciously occurred in the eastern section of its broad caldera, which is right next to the site of an eruption in 1955. Whether these quakes are occurring due to the movement of magma, are due to melting water that might generate a small jökulsárlóp, or have a separate origin is unclear. Although these two earthquake swarms are indeed suspicious, their intensities have both declined as of the writing of this video. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Renee Nolting, for supporting this channel.